December 15th, 61, yes, just the other day, I read the morning paper to see what it did say. The picture on the front page, it struck my heart with woe. I saw two women standing by a dead child in the snow. One woman lifted a blanket to see a dead child's face. Some books, some boots, some Christmas cards were scattered around the place. Another one, she hid her eyes, she couldn't bear to see. Saying, tell me to her neighbor, does this child belong to me? Still another one, she hid her eyes, she could not bear to look at the torn paper lunch bag and the blood-stained spelling book. While at the bottom of the page, here's what it said to me. Down, running 79 miles an hour for Denver, she was bound. She was coming from Chicago, running 90 minutes late, and it really Colorado tortured her fate. Herbert Summers was the engineer of that southbound passenger train. He saw the school bus on the tracks and he tried to stop in vain. He said the bus rolled on the tracks right after it slowed down. Now twisted steel and broken lives lie on the frozen ground. Said Summers, I am 64 and there's nothing I could do. And I've been on that same railroad since I was 22. Dwayne Arms, the driver of the bus, said I am 23. I've been driving since September, yes, this job's quite new to me. Well, I think I stopped, I usually do, that's what the driver said. And in the armory of the National Guard, only 20 children dead. Don't question him, he's deep in shock, I heard a doctor say. A mother stood and stared while I turned her back and walked away. Well, they booked him on the charge, and I read on down to see if the jury found him guilty, what his penalty would be. Well, the jury found him guilty, and the evidence was clear. The jury did convict him, but his sentence